Hello everybody and welcome to Green Star Trading with me Tom. All views, opinions and ideas expressed in this video are my own and do not constitute financial or trading advice in any way. Right, for the next few minutes we're going to be looking at both gold and silver. I'm going to start including both of them into the same video each week from now on, as I either end up sacrificing one for the other or using up two video slots when I could potentially put out additional content during the week. So put the two together, see how much time it takes, see if it fits, see if people like it. So without further ado, let's get underway, and we're going to do our Elliott wave count first, and then we're going to do our basic technical analysis at the end of the video. We're starting with gold here on the weekly time frame. Now I'm starting on the weekly time frame as I've had a couple of queries lately asking me about my longer term view on gold. I've been so focused since we topped out back in August last year, and so focused on the recent price activity that I think some people have lost perception of the long term count. So let's just do a quick recap. Starting from a 2016 low, I'm looking at four waves on the primary degree complete, and we're now in the fifth. So 1, 2, 3, 4, now working up on the fifth. I don't have this placed as at an actual target or anything. It's just up there waiting for me to place it. Okay, so don't read too much into where the fifth is positioned. I like this count, and it subdivides well. And if we look at our indicators for a moment, we can see how the highest reading of momentum we've had in the MACD was here at the top of the three in August last year. So I wouldn't expect to see the peak of the five come back beyond this inside of the same wave degree at primary degree. So I like that. I also like how it fits inside of our pitchfork using our swing high, swing low off of our 1, 2. We can see that as we put in this three wave correction into the two, we tested the median line here, then we came up, tested the median line again, back down, and then up and out of the pitchfork in the free. So momentum peaking in the free, as we see also in our momentum indicators. So I like that, and it's a nice fit. So that's all good. So what we'll do now is we'll hide that, and we'll come down into the smaller time frame, and we'll have a look at more recent price action. So since bottoming in what I'm saying is a primary wave 4 essentially, let's come down to the 1 hour time frame. Since then we've just been impulsing up off of the low is how it looks to me. Now I've interpreted this in two different ways. We have our truncation double bottom here, which is a 3, 4, 5 at minute degree into minor C, into intermediate Y, into primary 4. Or I've got an alternative which says this is a 1, 2 of intermediate degree, and then off we go higher. I've kept both counts. Today we're looking at the one which relies on the truncated bottom. It doesn't really matter, because essentially either the 4 is here or the 4 is here. We're in the neighbourhood. So counting up from this low, working on our double bottom being the low, we've come up in minor wave 1, 2, then minute wave 1, 2, then minute wave 3, 4, I think, here with an A, B, C, 5 waves in the C expanding flat. And I think we're now coming up into a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2 again as we work our way up into a 5th minute wave. All of this is just bundled up here ready for me to place it. These are not based on targets. Now this could be a broader correction. This could be an A, B, C, A to here, A, B, C, or W, X, Y into a B perhaps, and then 5 waves down into a C. At the moment though, we continue to impulse higher, we continue to trend higher until we see a more sustained sideways correction or a breakdown. I'm going to continue to interpret this bullishly. You'll have to see how it looks by the time you watch this video tomorrow, see if anything has significantly changed. But for the moment, this count is intact, things are continuing to head higher, gold looks strong. Right, so still waiting for those 5 waves to complete to get a bigger correction on a larger wave degree. So I still think we've got some room to go. Right, so that's gold. I don't think there's anything else to discuss really. So let's come over and have a look at the silver market. And we're going to look at our running flat completed wave 2 count into a primary wave 3. So this is our primary count for silver, which is we've done a 1. We've done an A, B, C, ending in a diagonal of the C into a primary 2. And then now we're heading up into a primary 3. Once again, target's not placed, and all these numbers are just essentially floating around waiting for me to place them. We are waiting for the same thing we have been waiting for a long time, which is a new high. A move above 28 in an impulsive move off of this low, taking us to an all-time high. This would give me much more confidence in this being a completed wave 2 and that we're not going to come back down lower. Now, so far, counting in the similar vein to how gold has been counting, we've been moving up 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5. So we're at the same minute degree in silver as we are in gold. We've got a slightly different setup as we're not starting with the minor 1, 2 already in. I'm suggesting that the minor 1, 2 isn't in yet. Now, I'm giving that the benefit of a doubt because I think we're going into a primary 3. So what we're actually going to see in this first move is the first extension. So we go 1, 2, then we'll go 1, 2, 1, 2 into smaller scale into the 3, as the 3 will likely be the longest of the waves and extend the furthest. Now, so far in our minute wave degree, moving up thusly, we've had a zigzag, very sharp zigzag here in the 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we've had an A, B, C, so a running flat, expanding flat, with the A, the B expanding beyond where the A began, and the C completing beyond where the A completed. And we got a 38.2% retracement for the wave 4 from the start of the wave 2, which is the perfect retracement for a wave 4. We came straight to that and found support. Correction could be over, and now we could be importing higher. I say could be because this first initial move after a completed correction, we're all making assumptions until we see something more significant, something where we can point to a 1 and then a 2. So far, we are probably going to continue to impulse up like this. If we do come down lower and we break this 25.08 level at 38.2, we break through this, but maybe we can consider this as an A, this is a B, and then this is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, heading into a deeper correction, potentially a completed 1, 2. But until we see a more sustained correction or breakdown in price, we can't be certain that we've completed any significant wave degree yet. So we're going to continue to count the waves as they develop. We've had a retracement here for a potential wave 4. We'd like to see another high and then push up into another 5 waves to find minute 5. Ideally, we'd like to find it above into a new high, because obviously this would be a breakout of the old high. This would likely draw more money in, and then we would likely have a crash. Well, not a crash, but a significant breakdown into a 2 immediately afterwards, or very soon afterwards, because, well, two reasons. One, we've broken the bearish pattern, and therefore we don't want to buy here, we want to buy cheaper, and therefore the market will sell off. And two, it draws in liquidity from people who break out traders, or people who see a new high and they come pouring in, and it will hurt them while allowing others who've been waiting for a pullback to buy it cheaper. And this just tends to be the way the market works. It's not malicious in intent or anything like that, it just tends to work that way. You know, just when people gain confidence is normally when they get trapped at the top, just when they lose confidence they get trapped at the bottom, or they give up at the bottom, I should say. It's just the way it tends to work. So that's how I see the running count in silver. That was the running completed count going into a primary wave 3. This is the alternate. This is a large expanding flat in a wave 2, which is yet to complete, and we're still in. We're not in a primary wave 3 by this count. This has a primary wave 2 completing later, and this is all one gigantic expanding structure. This is a very bearish count in the short term, but a very bullish count in the long term. I mean, apparently the 3 is going back in time. Like I said, it is not placed in any way as a target. It's literally just thrown up here ready for me to grab it when I need it. So let's just zoom back in on this lot. So this works on the idea of a large expanding flat. Let me just show you what I mean. So we've had our move down here, we've had our WXY into our B wave, and now we've got, and this is an A to here, B to here, 5 waves here in a C. So this is a flat, this is a double combination, and then this is a 1 leading diagonal rather than an ending diagonal, 1 into a 2, and now we should accelerate down in a 3. If this is correct, then we would get down, we would get moving quickly, and we should break down violently. It hasn't happened yet, so I'm leaning, I'm still, this is why the bullish count is still my primary. We have broken out of this channel, suggesting that either this in the impulsive count is either some kind of completed wave degree, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into a 1 perhaps, and then we've broken out of that channel looking for a deeper correction into a 2, or this is the corrective move, three wave move A, B, C as a zigzag into a 2, bringing us pretty much directly to C equals A parity here at 26.49. We came pretty much to the tick, and then we started to move down, back up, came even closer to it, suggesting this is either an internal swing or this needs to be moved across one space. So we'd have to go 3, it's like 5C2 here, but then this swing looks a bit awkward as an impulse, 3-4 like that. Then we've got the issue of counting this, so it all starts to go a bit off here, really. So it's not a very good fit. We get a swing here, maybe, that is that valid? 3 ABC expanding 1 2 3. You can't really get 5 waves here into the C either. So essentially, although we've stayed inside this channel and we've come to A equals C parity, the end bit of the count here gets a bit tricky. This does to me look more like an expanding correction, hence why in the bullish count is labeled 3 4 ABC. So I'm still leaning into the bullish count that we should, having completed this 3 4 ABC, we should start to accelerate back up again. If we don't and we break down violently, then we can come and look at this, and we can also start to look at the possibility of counting a completed impulse wave to a high and then looking for a more significant retracement if we break the 38.2 again. So we'd be looking for a 50 or 61.8% retracement from the high here for a potential wave 2. That would be a good, then we'd be waiting for a reaction from that level, so 5 ways up, 3 ways back on a smaller time frame to get back in and get long. If that level were to break, we have our invalidation point down here at 23.78. So if we were to continue to break down here violently, we could say, right, this impulse wave is completed, we've come back beyond where we'd expect to retrace, we have to potentially shift our attitude into a more bearish stance. But that's all complete conjecture. So for the meantime, silver's impulsing up off of a low, gold is impulsing up off of a low. Neither have shown a significant correction yet. We are still waiting for a significant correction in both of them, but the wave count so far does not look complete. And then there's the bearish interpretation, which if we do see a violent breakdown quickly, we can come back and look at this. Okay then guys, that's where I'm going to leave it for the Elliott wave count. So let's do some quick basic analysis here. We're going to come out to the weekly time frame on gold as soon as the chart unfreezes. Been a bit temperamental lately. Okay, so zoom in on all this, and then we'll hide the count, and we'll bring up our exponential moving averages, 10 in yellow, 20 in blue, 60 in orange, 250 in green. We'll bring up our momentum indicators as well, and we'll pick on this chart for silver. Come out again to the weekly time frame, zoom in on all this, hide the count, and then we'll go 10, 20, 60, 250. I haven't got my volume profile up. Okay, and weekly as well. So, we'll start here with silver since we're already here. Let's hide the favourites bar. Okay, so still zoomed out in the weekly time frame. Still looks like a 5-way swing to me at the moment. Whether it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 done, or whether it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to come. Still looking like a 5-way swing. Hanging around our point of control here on the visible range, not surprising. This is a long extended correction we've been going through since autumn last year. You know, we've been it's amazing how fast time flies, doesn't it? In a couple of months' time, we'll be basically talking about a year's worth correction if we don't make a new high. Above the 10, above the 20, above the 16, above the 250 exponential moving averages. Tested the 10 to the tick last week. Had this long wick to the upside. It's not a hammer, as the wick is not twice the length of the body, but it's still a long wick to the downside, which is quite bullish. A bullish engulfing for the week here, breaking to a new high, would be a positive. But it is Friday, so we've got to get a move on. We'd have to do that today. So you'll know better than me whether or not that happened. RSI have not done a round trip from overbought to oversold. At wave 2 primary degree, something tells me we should have. It's not a necessity, don't have to, just feels like a more significant correction should have occurred. But with a running flat, that's very, very bullish, because the C fails to extend beyond where the A completed. So this shows an underlying bid under the price action in the market, an underlying bid which continues to produce higher lows, low, higher low, probably another higher low, so on and so forth, till we break out to new all-time highs. MACD is still slightly bullish at the moment, some bullish momentum dying off. short-term moving average is crossed over the long-term moving average here, 10 over the 20. No move back into overbought yet, come down to the daytime frame. Above the 10, above the 20, above the 60, above the 250, having tested the 20 exponential moving average yesterday to the tick, now heading higher. Hopefully you see, would like to see a nice thrust up today. That would be nice, because if we have gone A, B, C, 1, 2, we should be entering a 3, which we should get some bullish, pretty bullish price action if that counts correct. Been cooling off a little bit in the RSI here. We've got a slight divergence between the high on the 18th of May and the high on the 2nd of June. This is an A, B swing though, so an internal correction, not necessarily a way degree completion 3 and 5, but simply an A and B. So divergence like that isn't that uncommon, as we tend in this expanding pattern we finish lower than where we completed the first wave down, so that is often preceded by a divergence. Okay, what else have we got here? The MACD has been relatively bearish during this sideways correction, as you can see, since we're basically saying we peaked in minute 3, we've done ABC, we've been heading down. Short-term moving average, the blue, the 10 over the long-term average, the orange, the 20, both heading down together. 10 seems to be decelerating and curving back up. We see the bars on the histogram turning paler. No bullish crossover yet. Perhaps we'll see that today or early next week. Some kind of bullish move higher, if this bullish count is correct. If we don't, and we see some kind of violent breakdown, we'll consider our alternatives next time we come to look at gold and silver. So, all right. So there you go. I think that's have we looked? No, we haven't looked at gold yet, have we? So let's do this quickly. Weekly time frame above the 10, above the 20, above the 60. I like the look of this now, because we dragged the 20 and the 10 and the 20 down to the 60 exponential moving average with the price below it. We got a 10 through the 60, but we never got the 20 through the 60 on the weekly time frame with the price below it. That would have been a death cross, inverted commas. I don't tend to read into them too much, but it would have been fundamentally bearish to see. Since then we have had the 10 cross back over the 20, all moving averages now pointing back to the upside with the price above, fundamentally bullish. The 250 never even blinked during this whole correction, it's just continued to move higher, so not really registering on the longer time frame on the weekly here. A move from overbought to oversold on the weekly time frame. Only the smallest tick into oversold, but nice to see, because we're saying 3-4 overbought, oversold. Nice to see that round trip completed before starting another bullish move higher, heading towards overbought conditions already though, so like we've been saying, some kind of sustained pullback is on the cards when this completes. Bullish momentum has been building, but is now starting to slack off a little bit over the last couple of weeks. Some darker bars on the histogram here, short-term moving average starting to calm down. No sign of it rolling over yet. Let's come down to the daily time frame and have a look. Okay, so on the daily, trading at the 10 exponential moving average, above the 20, having wicked through it a couple of times. This is either a first move down, 1, 2, or a A, B, C before we correct into something bigger, or it's simply the 3, 4, and we're going to start impulsing higher again. Above the 60, above the 250. Now, on the daily time frame, we did drag that 60, 10, 20, and 60 all through the 250 with the price below it at the time it happened. This has essentially preceded our low. Here's the cross, what people call the death cross, and here's the low, we've since rallied out of it. If you wait for this death cross to occur, you're more likely to be finding the bottom and shorting the bottom than you are shorting any further breakdown. Now, that is not written anywhere to be absolutely true. It's a personal observation. I often see people dive in into a death cross or a bullish cross only to have discovered the bottom or the top, you know. So I prefer to look at the moving averages as support levels and essentially another form of momentum indicator plus price support from a fundamental, a basic analysis point of view, rather than as a buy sell, you know, signal. But that's just me. You want to use them on smaller time frames, maybe you have some success with them in that way. Either way, above all the major moving averages, we've gone from oversold on the daytime frame on our low to quite overbought on the daytime frame. So we've done another round trip up, so this could be the first wave completed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 perhaps, A, B, C to come. So the fact that we've done that and we've broken down from overbought conditions back into the neutral zone could suggest that a bigger correction is about to occur, but we haven't seen it yet. Breakdown in momentum as well, with the short term moving average crossing below the long term moving average, build up of red bars on the histogram. We've seen 1, 2, 3 complete waves here in the momentum in the histogram, supported with 1, 2, 3 waves here before rolling over. So this could be our 3 motive waves, couldn't it? This could be our 1, our 3, and our 5. 1, 3, and an extension in the 5, that would suggest. But either way, we see a 3 wave motive movement here. We see an oversold to overbought condition here. We see a sell-off. So perhaps we are heading towards a more sustained breakdown. That's not necessarily a bad thing. We need to call off a bit, get another buying opportunity. All right then, so suspicion that we have approached a temporary top at least, and are going to break down a little bit from the basic technical analysis. The count is not really in conflict with that, because if we do see a more significant breakdown, we can relabel to consider the possibility of 5 waves up here rather than 3, 4, and 5 to come. All right then guys, that's been a technical analysis of gold and silver. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you're new to the channel and you've liked what you've seen, please smash the like, subscribe, hit the little bell notification icon to remain informed of future video releases, and leave a comment in the comment section below if you want to. Thank you again, as always, to my patrons. And if you are interested in becoming a patron, it's a good time to do it near the start of the month. You can follow the link in the description box below. Go check out the different tiers. And if you're not following me on Twitter yet, there's a link to my Twitter feed there as well. All right, guys, take care. And that is likely me done for the week now. Busy this weekend. If I can get a video update out to you, I will. If not, it'll be next week. All right, guys, take care. Bye-bye.